нас прекрасная возможность появилась попасть внутрь террариума отделения рептилий зоопарка Сан-Диего, знаменитого зоопарка Сан-Диего. Как говорится, святая святых. Следуйте за нами.
So in our sections, anything that's venomous will actually have a venomous tag. That's our tag that we take in case we get bit.
Okay.
So if you get bit, you grab that tag, you pull this tag to you. On this tag has the common name, scientific name. Mm-hmm. If there is anti-venom, it'll have a letter. This one's none, it's a Gila monster. There's no anti-venom, but you're not gonna know. Yes. And then there'd be a medical thing. This one's just immobilized and let's sling.
That's really cool.
Yeah, so it's just a quick thing to grab. And
so it means it's quite a lot of people that can potentially have access to these gloves, right?
Yes.
Because if it would keepers, have just two specialists, it would not be maybe such a big issue. Right?
Yeah, and it's more because we handle them a lot.
Uh-huh.
So you have keepers who come in here and they might need to switch the water bowls, especially for Gila monsters who love to dig around and mess the water. We have to make sure you know the water's fresh, everything's clean. Gaboon vipers too, you know them, they might poop once a month, and when they do, it's pretty massive. So we got to go in there and be able to clean it out and move it. Some stuff has ship doors, which I'll show you down here. They're too big. So these main exhibits back here, these are the ones that the public see. So you're just kind of behind. This is all holding for a bunch of different reasons. It could be medical, it could be gravid, it could just be surplus that we need to move around. It's not set by continent. It's not just Africa. We have a little bit of everything. We just kind of set the temperature zone for what they need. Yes.
Мы,
so you can just mix
it. Мы в секторе содержания ядовитых змей. Определенные инструкции. Все четко, ясно. Люди знают, что делать в случае, если происходят какие-то эксцессы, непредвиденные действия. Все очень ответственно. Это один из шагов к responsible herpetoculture.
И офигенная фишка.
Да.
Каждое животное имеет свой описание. В случае, что что-нибудь случится.
В случае укуса
берется карточка, на нем
карточка
основные.
Берется, человек вешает на себя, чтобы с ним не произошло. Уже знают, как с тобой правильно поступать и когда тебя отвозить на кладбище.
This is our actual venom box. Each corridor has this.
Okay.
So if someone was to get bit, they would push this alarm here. It sends the horn off, which is loud, deafening loud.
Mm-hmm.
And then it actually contacts the ambulance and all our emergency responders. This is our backup. So this is so who for me or we have two people. Because when we work venomous, there's always two people in the room. This is what they can grab. And they can just go step by step.
Mm-hmm.
We want you to memorize it, but you know in the time of an emergency, sometimes you might not be there, or it's your best, you know, it's your good friend.
Yeah.
So you have this to kind of, you can look at that. You can go through.
Cheat sheet.
Yes, exactly. So secure the specimen. Now that if I was working, it'd be my job to do
Первое.
It.
Первое.
But if I got bit.
Положи животное в террариум. Повесь значок. Нажми аварийную сигнализацию. Вызови службу безопасности, сними с себя драгоценности. Также сделай себе первую помощь. Первая помощь, аптечка лежит здесь. И оттранспортируйте жертву укушенного к передней двери. Здесь обязательно должны находиться в этом отсеке два человека. Восьмое. Получите антивеном, получите записи вашего здоровья и конверт с протоколом. Все абсолютно регламентировано.
So these are bandit king cobras. These were actually confiscated at LAX. They came in little Chinese Pringle cans, little chip cans. And they actually just opened them up to see because they knew it wasn't right and they poked a hole in it. Little head just went, whoop, popped up. And then they secured them. So what they did is, LA Zoo, they don't have anti-venom for king cobra. We're the only ones to have it.
Mm-hmm.
So we went up there and assisted them with it. So we just took them all and brought them back down to the zoo. They grow super fast. I mean, these guys were maybe, you know, about yay size. They're all on rodents.
All down
they were one on rodents right away. Because as we know, king cobras usually just eat snakes.
Yes.
We're
so
sure
what they usually can get.
Yes.
Scented rodents.
So we usually scent and go. These guys went right away, which tells me these guys are probably getting fed over there to bring over as a pet trade. Because usually it takes us some time to get them to eat a rodent and not want a snake. But these guys readily eat. It's a great training snake too right now for new keepers to come and work with a king cobra. Because the bigger one is even more challenging. He has a lot of confidence. He's not shy. Yes. He'll come and look you right in the eyes.
Look in the eyes.
Yes.
And say, hey.
Hey. Yeah.
Are you worthy?
Yes.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Could you explain what you are doing here?
Okay, so this is our misting system for all our exhibits.
Система увлажнения для всех абсолютно экспозиций.
So the problem we had is our water in California is so hard. It like crystallized our glass.
Which is salt.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah,
right here.
There's salt. So a company comes and they just add the salt and then it goes through the carbon and it goes through.
We have same.
Yeah.
In our lab.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it really helps with glass cleaning. Mm-hmm. Water bowls though, we don't use this like for drinking water.
We don't
really use this. We just use some of the hose or like a carbon filter. Just because we have a lot of minerals and stuff in our water. The other things you'll see is these are the older enclosures we have. These are Neodesha, really good company, was around for quite some time. You might find these still every once in a while, but we're actually moving to more custom built with these things. I'll show you some other cages, but they're a little bit lower in the back, so we can put heat lamps a little bit further down and get the heat higher on the bottom. Because here we have space, like I can't put a heat lamp in here. But this one I could put one in the back. And then we have shift doors so we can pull this and they can have access, or we can close it and then they can stay separate from each other. So it's a really nice design. They're a little bit heavier than the Neodesha, but still light enough to just move around. So Eastern Diamondbacks. We have just a flow. We have Bushmasters, black-headed Bushmasters on exhibit. Some of the other Bushmasters here. And then we have some overflow Indian Python. Mm-hmm. The other thing that's cool that you can see is all the different tools a keeper will use when working. We don't want to disturb the snake every day. That's not our job. We want them to live their life peacefully. Yes, and let them do. So what can we do?
If you need to.
Yes, if we need to, we can move it. But what we do is with Bushmaster, they're in the far corner. You can use longer tongs with the big rabbits or rats and feed them at a safe distance. That's same with fecal. If they do poop, then you can use our spoons instead of moving the snake out trying to clean it. Other tongs that are cool that are on the market that we've tried from Midwest that we like for the big body snakes are these newer, I don't know if you guys seen these, the new double hook.
So they do not slide so easily.
Yes. With a big body snake, that's giving you more support. Where this one could put a lot of pressure on a rib and crack it, this one will actually distribute.
They are heavy,
yes,
right?
Exactly. Bushmasters.
They get nervous and they get
This holds them better. Yeah. So it's kind of nice to be able to have some.
Interesting. So this is for food.
This is for poop.
For poop.
Ah,
fecal. Cleaning the fecals.
Yeah, I understand.
This would be for this one. This long one is mostly for food. This one we can use on snakes. We rarely use our tongs for snakes. We usually just use our hooks. Yeah. Certain things you might want to, like for the mamba, sometimes you can hook them, but the problem is when we're trying to get them into a container, they don't want to cooperate. And you know, a mamba can go in and then just pop right back out. Mm-hmm. So we might use a gentler tong, a plastic one, that we can grab, just hold it, get the lid ready, and then move it and then seal it in. Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake. Big size. Some keepers can't physically move it. So we came up with the shift area for him. So right now it's closed, but it has a... So like he put, do not check snake through porthole when he's in there. When he's in there, he just pops it every time. So we can check from above. But this allows us to move the snake if we need to. Mm-hmm. So if he's too big for someone but he needs to go to the hospital, we can shift him in here. I can take the box and go to the hospital and then work him there.
How big it is?
He's probably about 5 feet. I don't know his weight. Mm-hmm. But he's pretty solid. At first he was kind of creepy. To me, I feel like he's calmed down a lot. He's not. I think he's gotten a little more. You get a little with people walking around up front. I think it really takes off the edge. You'll see too. One of them, we have higher ones. This was for like mambas, If they need to go, we have a box. We have one right there. A lot of people, guests, are like, there's a whole exhibit. Your manga's getting out. But no, it's going into a ship box that we have. And we just make that comfortable so the keeper doesn't feel comfortable working it.
I asked exactly these questions when I first saw it.
Yeah, because you see a hole.
Yeah.
And you see a snake coming in and out. Where's it going? But there's an actual secured box that it's going into.
So that's how the exhibition looks like. The opposite side that is not always accessible for visitors.
Canyon lizards are here.
Do you breed them?
We stopped. Mm-hmm. Right now, we don't need anything. I think with the SSP, the Species Survival Plan, there's no recommendations, so we kind of hold off. Mm-hmm. But we have in the past. We did have a juvenile. They probably moved it in one of these, and that's probably why you can't see it. It's smaller. This one usually has a bunch of different stuff. Some Erpaton. I like these guys.
Yeah,
it's like, you know, yes, they look like a stick. They don't do anything, but when you feed them, there's a lot to it. They're, you know, fast, how their jaw design. It's really cool.
Yeah.
And yes, just a very simple trash can sump. But it does the job.
Yeah, it does the job, no problem.
Yep.
Are they doing well in captivity?
Yes, ours have. We've bred them in the past too.
Feeding on fishes?
Just fish. Yeah. Yes. Twice a week we get these shiners that come in and they just gobble them up. We have, this is our holding, and then this is our main exhibit right here with them. Live bear, really cool. You don't really see them that much anymore. But just a cool snake that I think a lot of people are just kind of not familiar with. Or
is it Southeast Asia?
Southeast Asia, yeah. I got it in Vietnam. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But they are quite rare nowadays. I don't know why.
Yeah,
I don't get them.
Yeah.
I don't get them, for whatever reason.
I guess all these bright crocodile lizards are from Vietnam as well.
Yeah.
Not from China.
The Shinosaurus? So
yeah.
Those, some zoos are breeding those here. Mm-hmm. We're trying to get some more. We bred them a long time ago.
But they have the Chinese ones.
But yeah, we have Chinese ones, not Vietnamese.
I tried them.
Yeah.
Absolutely expressed by this fantastic collection of turtles in outdoor pool aquarium.
Yeah, that is one of my favorite exhibits. Yeah. I used to have that exhibit when I was a keeper, and I raised those babies. Those gerials came in as babies.
Mm-hmm.
So we came and I picked them up from LAX. We brought them here. There's 10 of them, and then we have 4. We shipped the other ones to other zoos. But I can remember I sat in that exhibit for a month, just to build that relationship with them, to them come to me. Because
mm-hmm.
And then pretty soon, now you go, we just fed them earlier today. And so trying to get other keepers, but in India where they train them, it's, they usually do that call buh to feed. So I do it, but if you have a lower voice, they just kind of like, they ignore it. Yeah. They want that deep. So we might switch it to like cone training or other targets to get them to come.
Condition for carriers and turtles.
Oh, that down there?
Quite new?
Yeah, the gerials we've had probably for about 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The turtles we've had a lot longer. Mm-hmm. That exhibit was built, I want to say, in early 2000. Because when I first started at the zoo in 2000, it was still the 3 pits. It was like an alligator, a turtle, and something else. And it's shortly after that, in 2000, 2001, they made that exhibit.
But still looks like perfect.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And what about Komodo Dragons exhibition? Is it closed?
Yes. So what they're doing is they're currently tearing it down, mm-hmm. and they're going to make a brand new exhibit in 2 years. And it looks fabulous. Brett's been designing it. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be really exciting.
Two different groups, and this is the Sora group. They're from a little different area.
So they are from Brazil?
From Panama.
Okay.
Are they in danger?
Yeah, they're gone. They're pretty much excavated.
Here we see the exposition of antilopes from Panama. Rare species, bespotted amphibians, who are still under threat of extinction.
Помещение с гигантскими саламандрами.
They grow fast.
They grow fast.
Yeah, I knew they
grow fast. What is the temperature you keep them at?
63.
63 is proper. Yeah.
Like 16.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
They can survive.
So this we have monitors in here and some of the rattleless rattlesnakes, the Catalina. And these enclosures. The Gila monster is in there, or one Gila monster. So there's the rattleless rattlesnake. And you can see these cages, these are the ones we're replacing. Mm-hmm. All of these with the newer ones.
This is Echotera production.
These ones?
No. Yes, yes. It's highly flattered.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay. It's the old attack. Now they look different. It looks like Zuma.
No,
Zuma.
Zuma.
This is Zuma.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. This is Zuma. Yeah.
Nice ones.
Oh, I have them.
I think they're 3 years old. 3 years old.
They're so okay.
A little, this one is, this guy was born last year, it's a little, the rattleless rattlesnake. Mm-hmm. I think that one is gonna have babies.
Find their nests out there in that exhibit. And so he's almost big enough to go out in the exhibit.
Well, so I'll show you where we keep the adults.
Oh, yeah. Very interesting.
Because we have them out. Did you go down and see them outside?
Yes.
Nothing, we haven't had anything in there happen.
Too hot.
It might be too hot in there. It gets really cold in the winter.
Do you bromate them?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. But in the canyon where they are, it gets really cold mm-hmm. in the winter, but it also won't get hot. But it's still down in that canyon. It's not too hot, but maybe too hot for them.
Yeah, one single hill in southern China. Southern China is quite cold.
Quite cold, yeah.
Quite cold.
But I think every zoo with a good reptile department should be happy to have them.
Yeah. Well, we had 34.
hatch last year.
Wow.
Two clutches.
How many eggs from one female?
We got, let's see, 19, and then what the other half?
Well, 19?
16 from one and then 16.
And how many hatched?
All of them.
All of them?
Yeah, all of them hatched, yeah. I think there were, I think out of the 19, there was actually 23, and those didn't hatch. The five of the four of those. Mm-hmm.
For how long do you keep them in San Diego?
2002, I think.
Okay, quite, quite long.
Yeah.
So in what age do they mature?
I don't know yet.
3 years.
Because we got them, they were adults. Yeah.
Uh-huh. So you still do not have a babies which reproduce, which grow up and they reproduce?
No.
Mm-hmm. Incubation temperatures are also low.
82.
82.
82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82. 82.